Greetings. We are preparing to embark on a wonderful journey. We will climb mountains and swim oceans. Together, we will be enthralled and embrace emotions that can only be touched by the sounds of classical music. Get ready to travel from the old world to the heavens and back as we are transported with melodies from the masters that will propel us through the centuries. I'm David Ogden Stiers. This is Classical Rewind 2 on My Music.
For those of you that enjoy classic TV, we have lost an incredible actor. We have just lost David Ogden Stiers. He died of cancer today. He died peacefully at home. But we've lost a fantastic actor today. What I would say that he was most known for, obviously, is Major Charles Emerson Winchester III on the television series MASH, which is one of my favorite shows of all time. Now, I didn't know he was on the Dead Zone, but he was. And, of course, I knew him long before I was a big MASH fan. I mean, I watched MASH when I was 3, but didn't really understand it. As the clock from Beauty and the Beast, so Cogsworth. But I'm going to kind of go through a few things he has been in, just to kind of show you how long and just how important he was. He played a lot of roles. He was on Rhoda for 2 episodes. He was on 3 episodes of the Mary Tyler Moore Show. Let's see, he was in North and South. Interesting. He was in a lot of Perry Mason TV films from the mid-80s. He played the district attorney. He was in an episode of ALF, 2 episodes of ALF. He was on Matlock, even more Perry Mason. Oh, he was on CBS school break specials. Oh, wow. He was also the narrator in Beauty and the Beast. He was on Star Trek Next Generation, which is one of the episodes that I love, called Half a Life. Half a Life, I'll explain this here real quick. It was in the 4th season, which is when it really started getting good. And basically, Troy falls in love with this guy named Timison. And he's trying to find theories of stellar ignition, hoping to save his world's dying star. And the experiment doesn't work, and Troy wants him to continue doing it, but he's about to turn 60, and in his culture, turning 60 means that you must prepare for ritual suicide, and she's trying not to get him to do it, and in his culture, obviously, they voluntarily choose to do euthanasia to keep from becoming a burden on a younger generation, which, it's a really, really hard episode to watch, not because of, like, what it's meaning. It's just a sad, sad story, and it does so well for Troy. And I'm saying Troy, and I'm not talking about the young Troy. I probably should have been more specific. I'm talking about Michelle Barrett's character, Loxana Troy, who falls in love with him because they're around the same age. Obviously, the younger Troy would not be falling in love with David Ogden Stiers at this point, so it's called Half a Life. If you have access through Amazon and several other, I know Amazon has some of the stations. I'm not sure. Netflix does as well. Check that episode out. It's really good, and it does show how good of an actor he was. Of course, there are too many episodes to even count of MASH that he was in that are very, very good. I'm trying to think of some. One of my favorite ones is when he's playing horn and driving them nuts and they finally run his horn over. Or when they give him too big a pants and he thinks he's losing weight and he starts eating a whole lot. And then they give him his regular pants back and he gained all the weight. Or, and even some of the ones like when he's supposed to be this really bad guy and he's going around and making sure that kids in, you know, the Korean area have clothes and food on Christmas. That was a wonderful episode. Or just him not wanting to fail and wanting to be great at what he was. He was a really good, kind of yin to Hawkeye's Yang in that, and I really did enjoy it. Just give us some more things that he was in. He was in The Majestic, and it was so neat to see him in The Majestic. I think that's a great film. He was on a few episodes of Touched by an Angel. He was in the series Lilo and Stitch as Dr. Jumba Zhuikaba. I've never seen that. I just knew that he was in that, and I thought that was kind of neat. I obviously was a little too old for Lilo and Stitch, but he was in that as well. He was the narrator for Lady in the Water, if anybody remembers that. He was on Stargate Atlantis. He was on The Regular Show. And he was in Toonstruck, the video game, which I found that to be super neat. He was also in Myst 5. And, of course, he was in the Kingdom Hearts games, you know, where he played his characters. I can't really think of anything negative that I would want to say about him. He was a fantastic actor. And he went to the Juilliard School of Music. He was a conductor and he played instruments. That's another one of these things that's so much why I like him. Him being, you know, a conductor of music, which obviously that's what I am. Now, it's kind of neat. His first work was on one of George Lucas's early films, the THX 1138, which some people probably didn't know that he was in. I always thought that was neat as well. He was in so much. He was on, I didn't know he was on Frasier for an episode. I'd need to find that. I really like Frasier. I've watched quite a bit of that. But, I'm kind of going to put, like, what his role was on MASH here. So, in 1977, you know, he came in after they got rid of Burns, which, Major Burns was a great character. I think they kind of ran out of ideas what to do with him, so he didn't really want to be on the on the show anymore. Larry Linville was a fantastic actor, and so Frank Burns just kind of went away. He was so, you know, the buffoon kind of stuff. But Winchester comes in as a well-spoken and talented surgeon who presented a different type of foil to Hawkeye and BJ Honeycutt. You know, Burns usually was the butt of jokes and then frequently was, you know, made fun of for insults, and he had no way to get back, and then he was not a good surgeon either. Winchester, though, was a very good surgeon and just about as good as them. And he was also as good at getting them back in the prank. So instead of just being the butt of everything, he actually could get them back sometimes just as good. And really where he was, you know, a little snobby and, you know, didn't enjoy their jokey behavior, he became a target for them. And, you know, obviously he did align himself with them a little bit more than what Major Burns ever would. And he did have admiration for Colonel Potter, which such a great, great actor. He was also nominated for 2 Emmys for playing him. He did not win them, unfortunately, but he was nominated. I saw this just about 10 minutes ago that he had passed, and it hit me hard right away. I was just like, oh, great, one of my favorites. You know, we're starting to lose MASH characters, you know, and we've lost quite a few. If you've never watched MASH and you're on my channel, you should take the time to watch MASH. It's a fantastic show. It's more about Vietnam than Korea, obviously, but it is what it is on that. You know, that was what was going on at the time. So I recommend looking him up. I'm going to go ahead and watch a few episodes tonight and probably watch the Star Trek Next Generation episode. So this has been Chris. Have a good evening. Thanks for listening. And stay tuned when we get back to happier things. So thanks for listening, everybody. Bye now.